A toddler found wandering out in the cold, alone, no shoes, no jacket. We now know who police say will face charges. New this noon, police are telling us the people who were supposed to be watching the boy didn't even know his name. Good afternoon, I'm Mike Clark. Sally is on assignment. Let's get right to Channel 4 Action News reporter Amber DeCocha with brand new information on exactly what happened. Amber?
Yes, police tell us the people who were watching the little boy will be facing child endangerment charges after that two-year-old walked out of the home without any coat or any shoes. And for neighbors, they say they were not only surprised, but they were very concerned not knowing who that little boy belonged to.
He was out here running around in his socks. And it was sad. It's really sad to see that.
One day after a two-year-old boy was found walking outside all alone without shoes or a jacket, neighbors are still shocked.
But the police did have the baby. They put him in the car, and everybody on the block come out, and they tried to, you know, identify the boy.
A neighbor found the boy. The child's mother tells us she left her son and four-month-old daughter with her boyfriend's father and sister to attend parenting classes just before the toddler wandered off. But police tell us when they questioned 59-year-old Elmer DeVore and 20-year-old Jessica DeVore, neither could tell officers the child's name. Feeling they were incapable of caring for the kids, officers removed the children from the home. The mother spoke with Channel 4 shortly after asking her face not be shown.
I should have took him today, and I should have. And it was my mistake, but it does not qualify me for losing my children.
Police say the mother will likely not face any charges, but both Elmer and Jessica DeVore will. The mother tells us she fears this could happen again because this is not the first time her two-year-old has wandered off.
And he has done it. He has gone out my apartment door and gone always constantly going over to my mom's next door. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And there's things where you can't child-proof a house because you're either under Section 8 or you're not allowed to put screws in and stuff like that.
Now, the children remain in the care of Washington County Children, Youth, and Family Services. As for Jessica and Elmer DeVore, well, they will likely be charged sometime this afternoon. Reporting live from Washington County, Amber Nicotra, Channel 4 Action News.